Our first loom lesson of week two back after Easter. This is a continuation of the cloning lesson that hopefully you did last week. We're now going to be focusing in on adult cell cloning, which is a technique for cloning animals. You have a do now as always. Please could you pause the video now and complete the do now. Okay, on to the answers. So, two methods of cloning plants, cuttings and tissue culture. Number two, you produce many identical offspring in tissue culture as opposed to cloning. For number three, remind you, it's that long process of embryo cloning or embryo transfer. So, you will begin by giving the animal you are interested in with fertility hormones. This will stimulate her to produce lots of eggs. You will then collect those eggs. You will artificially inseminate the eggs. You will then allow one to develop to an embryonic stage. You will then take cells from that initial embryo. So you can start with one large ball. You will take cells from each to grow identical offspring. You will then implant them or transplant them into a surrogate mother. The mother will then give birth to young that is identical to the biological mother, not the surrogate mother. So the red shift provides evidence for the Big Bang and the fact that the universe is still expanding. So does cosmic microwave background radiation, CMBR. We can't be exactly sure because it's very long ago and no one was about at that time. So we're interested in cloning farmers in particular because they can make organisms that are disease resistant, that have a high milk yield, large muscle capacity, whatever the characteristic is that they need. So iron 2 ions will produce a green precipitate when reacted with sodium hydroxide, whereas iron 3 will produce a brown precipitate when reacted with sodium hydroxide. Now, the way that I remember this is a bit gross. I always think iron 2, it reminds me of having a number 2, which colloquially number 2 means for you to have a poo. You then think, oh, poo is normally brown, but wait, that's not right in this scenario. Iron 2 is green. Iron 3, which you wouldn't think, is the brown one. I don't know if that'll help you. It may not, but it helps me. Okay, moving on. So, July the 5th, 1996. It was a landmark scientific achievement. It wasn't my birthday, in case any of you were wondering that. But who knows why this day was so important. Okay. It was the time that the first successful clone of a mammal was carried out. It took 276 attempts. They managed to produce a chick clone known as Dolly. It was made from the udder cell of a six-year-old sheep. Since then, other animals besides cattle and sheep have been cloned. For example, cats, deers, dogs, horses, mules, oxes, rabbits, rats. As well as that, a rhesus monkey has been cloned by embryo transfer, embryo cloning. The process we looked at last lesson. So, shown here as well is Cece. You've got the rather large, fat-looking cat on the left. That is the mother of the small little cat on the right. That small little cat on the right is known as Cece, standing for carbon copy. She is genetically identical to the cat on the left. The cat on the right, the large one, was her surrogate mother. Now, there are companies out there. Apologies. I'll start again. Now, there are companies out there that allow you to clone your pets. We're going to take a brief look at one of them now. Okay, so one of the companies that allows you to clone your pets is Viagen. I'm not sure how it's pronounced. We're going to look a brief look, because I think it's quite interesting, at the frequently asked questions about this company. So they currently provide cloning services for dogs and cats. If you look here about the time it takes, So once you submit your sample, they'll get back to you within 4 weeks to say whether it's feasible or not to clone your animal. It will then take approximately another 100 days and you'll have a cloned cat. There's so many questions here. I'm not going to go through them all, but if any of you are interested, please do have a look at it. It's quite an interesting idea. Anyway, it's quite an interesting idea. So we'll look very briefly at what is a clone dog or cat. So it's exactly genetically identical. Like we learned about clones, it's a genetically identical organism or offspring. So they use somatic cell nuclear transfer, which we are going to look today in the GCSE. We call it adult cell cloning. And that is the process that we are going to be looking at in this lesson. Okay, back to the PowerPoint. So adult cell cloning. This is a technique that has been used to make Dolly the sheep and, for example, that little cat known as Cece. So you have your sheep A, your sheep B here. I would advise at the end of this to get the diagram down as well. So what you do, you remove the adult cell from the sheep you are interested in cloning, the sheep you want to make a copy of. You remove the nucleus from that adult cell. You then have a second sheep. You take a mature egg with a nucleus inside of it from that sheep. You remove the nucleus, giving you an empty egg. You then combine the empty egg from sheep B and the nucleus from sheep A. You get them to fuse together by giving them a mild electric shock. So as it says here, nucleus from sheep A fuses with empty egg from sheep B. It will then start to divide to form an embryo. You then implant this cloned embryo into a third sheep. That final lamb will then be born and it'll be genetically identical to sheep A. It won't be related genetically to sheep B or sheep C in any way. Okay, moving on. Here's just another diagram if it helps you to understand the process again. I'm not going to talk through it again, but I just wanted to give you several images in case that helped. So, here is the instructions that I just said, the method I just said, and the picture. Please pause the video, record the method and the picture. Okay, we're going to have a briefer tangent now, where we're going to look at some of the uses of adult cell cloning. An incredibly interesting one is something known as the de-extinction project. Okay, so they are looking at bringing back past animals. So if you are interested in this, please do type in the de-extinction project online. They're looking at things like passenger pigeons, and the main fancy one is the woolly mammoth. Now, whilst this isn't a straight example of adult cell cloning, it does contain certain similarities. And it's a way that the examiners could ask about this topic. One thing I want you to be thinking about is it ethically right to bring back species we have made extinct back from the dead? So is that ethically okay to do? There's not a clear answer here. I'm just interested in your opinion. Okay, looking at some of the benefits of animal cell cloning or adult cell cloning. So the benefits of adult cell cloning. Number one, it allows us to save endangered species. Please recall these reasons as we go through. So adult cell cloning allows us to save endangered species. I've given you an example here. For example, the example is Noah. Noah was the name of a species of ox called Gur. It was incredibly vulnerable. And through this technique, they're looking at being able to reintroduce to save this endangered species. Similar to the de-extinction project. So, it can allow us to clone pets or prized animals. So maybe you've got an animal that has a desired characteristic. You could take the nucleus from that animal, place it into an empty egg cell, give it a mild electric shock, put it in a, implant it in a surrogate mother, and you'd have babies that have that really high milk yield or whatever characteristic you want. It could be number of leaves if you're looking at plants, or number of fruits, and pets as well. It allows us to clone our pets, which might have a sentimental value to us. The third reason is it allows us to create medically beneficial animals. For example, pigs have been cloned that contain organs that will not be rejected by the human body. Getting organs from pigs has been used for a long time. A large issue with this is that our immune system would reject some of these organs and would try and fight against them. Creating cloned pigs that can't be rejected, that organs can't be rejected, would be a massive step forward in this field known as xenotransplantation. Okay, so those are your three reasons. Please make sure you've recorded them down. On to the problems. A large problem surrounds the idea of it being abused. So people worry about creating designer babies. They worry about people choosing their offspring to have certain colored eyes, certain colors hair. So there's a large worry over the idea this might be abused. So actually, currently, it is not ethically acceptable to experiment on humans. This has unfortunately been done, supposedly, in a study in China, one I mentioned last lesson. The other issue with adult cell cloning and any type of cloning is that if you make all your organisms genetically identical, that's super duper when the conditions are suited. But if you get any kind of environmental change, that variety that they need to survive won't be present. So one disease could potentially wipe out the whole community. Okay, so we're going to look at a few exam questions now. Number one, modern scientists use cloning techniques. Tick the box of the cloning technique used to produce clone plants. Okay, I hope you've had time to record your answer. The correct answer is taking cuttings from plants. Now, I'm showing you a method here. We've looked at two methods of cloning in animals: embryo transfer, embryo transplant. It has many different names, annoyingly. And adult cell cloning, which method is shown in the diagram here? Okay, this one is adult cell cloning. I also really like this picture. The reason I like it is if you look carefully, it's kind of flipped the normal order. So the female person A is at the top. That is where you're getting your egg from. You remove the egg from that nucleus. Person B is where you're getting your nucleus from. You take a body cell, you take the nucleus out. So cell W will be genetically identical to person B. It's so careful, so important that you check in what order the diagram is set up. I hope that makes sense. Okay, you're now going to write a large extended written question about this. Okay, now I know this is something we've done before, and it's harder, I understand, at the time. At the moment. So I'm going to try and talk you through it as much as possible. So you're going to use information from the diagram above and your own knowledge to describe how adult cell cloning could be used to clone a zorse. So the zorse is the animal on the left, which is half horse, half zebra. You're describing how to use adult cell cloning. You will start, I will get you started. The first thing you'll talk about is, I would say, a skin cell is removed from the zorse. The nucleus is removed from this skin cell. I would then go to talk about the horse, what you take from there. I would then talk about how you get them to fuse together. I would then talk about the final horse in the bottom left, about it being a surrogate. I would then make it incredibly clear what that final offspring is genetically identical to. I hope that has helped in some way. Please pause the video and have a go at answering this question. Okay, so here are the answers. In order to get in the 5 to 6 bracket, which is where we've got to be aiming for, you need to have a clear, detailed description of all the major points. Okay, so for example, you could say, the skin cell from the Zeus is removed. The unfertilized egg cell, or just an egg cell, is okay, from a horse is removed. You remove the nucleus from the egg cell. You take out the nucleus from the skin cell, shown in the diagram here. You would then put the nucleus from the skin cell into the empty egg cell, into the egg cell. If it's in brackets, that means you don't explicitly need to have that word. You then give it an electric shock to get it to fuse together. You allow the embryo to form or the egg cell to divide. You place that embryo into the surrogate mother, into the uterus of the surrogate mother. If you haven't used the word uterus, I think that's completely okay, only you've spoken about the surrogate mother. Okay. Please mark check tick correct as needed. Another question. I'm going to allow you to read through this yourself. I want you to tell me how the process of using adult cell cloning to clone a pet animal is different to using adult cell cloning to bring an animal back to life. Okay, the reason why it's different when you use adult cell cloning to clone a pet animal, sorry, to clone an extinct animal, is you have to use two different species. Okay, so for example, if we go back to the extinction picture for the mammoth, you have to use DNA from the mammoth. You then have to use, so that's one species, you then implant it into an embryo. Of sorry, into an elephant. So you're using your two different species. Whereas if I was trying to bring a pet back to life, it would all be in one species. For example, if I was bringing Vesuvius back to life, it would all be in cats. So when you're trying to bring an organism back to life from the dead, you have to use more than one species. Okay, I want you to evaluate the use of adult cell cloning to conserve, to preserve endangered species. So use the information given and your own knowledge and understanding. So whether you think it's right to do or you think it's wrong to do. This could relate to our kind of ethical responsibility as humans to preserve organisms for future generations. I think this is a very hard question and isn't explicitly on what you've been taught today. It's kind of a wider learning one and one that you will study in more detail when we return to school. So if you get stuck on it, that's completely okay. Please pause the video now. Okay, here is your answer. So the pros of using adult cell cloning to conserve endangered species. Number one, it's good if it's hard to get species to breed. Pandas are a great example. They hate to breed in captivity. Adult cell cloning would be a way around increasing their numbers. It stops them from going extinct. That's the second pro. Now the cons. The cons. You can find some of these cons from this large bit of text here. It has a low success rate. Cloning reduces the gene pool, therefore they could all be wiped out if a new disease come along. Sometimes when you clone these animals, they live for a very short amount of time, so you can have development problems. Finally, I just need an argued conclusion. Okay, just suggesting why you suggested what you said. Tell me which way you go. All right, this question is out of 4 marks. I know it's a difficult one. Please just put the corrections in. It's a sentence we will return to in lesson. All right, guys, I hope you are well. Thank you for listening. Have a great week. On Thursday, I will not be posting another video. Instead, I'll be posting a reading task, okay? But the week after, I'll be posting another video or another two videos again. All right, hope you are well. Look after yourselves. Thank you for listening.